If you're using VH, viewport height, to set the height on things like sections, be careful because it's very likely that it's not doing what you think it's doing. Four things to cover in this lesson. We'll cover the big problem with viewport heights. Then we'll cover some of the newer and better CSS viewport units like DVH and SVH, when to use which. And finally, we'll talk about why you should never, ever, ever set a value to height in CSS and why doing so can potentially destroy your site and any device accessing it. If we have time, we'll talk about why that sentence isn't 100% true. Part one, VH. A lot of people set the height of something like a section to 100 VH, 100% of the viewport height. The problem is the viewport height on a lot of devices changes. We expect 100 VH to do this, but it actually does this. And that's because there's a dynamic toolbar thing and you're losing stuff behind the browser UI. Now, some people set the height to 90 VH or 80 VH just to be safe, but that's not really scientific, nor does it solve what VH is trying to solve in the first place. So how do we develop using better CSS? Part two, development using better CSS. What a lot of people say is use DVH or dynamic viewport height. This actually works sometimes, but not how you'd think. Here's what DVH does. DVH adjusts the content based on the browser UI stuff. Here's 100 VH again, and here's 100 DVH. VH, DVH. VH, you get the idea. But there's something slightly worse going on now. The toolbar, because it's appearing and disappearing when you scroll up and down, this changes that section height. DVH is dynamic, so it's only doing what we told it to do. And if we have like 20 sections, each set to 100 DVH, the browser UI is going to dramatically change the height of your page. Because each section's height is changing too, the problem compounds, and your website visitors will be furiously frustrated. So it's time to introduce SVH, small viewport height. SVH will calculate the height just like DVH when the page loads, but it won't resize itself when the browser UI pops back up or disappears. Put simply, SVH is the best of both worlds. However, there's still a problem with all this stuff. Part four is all about setting heights. If you set a div or a section or anything that has content, if you set anything in the CSS height property when it has content inside, there is a huge risk. And this applies to anyone using SVH or VH or pixels or rems, whatever. Why is setting the height so dangerous? Watch what happens. Image, heading, paragraph, button, all in a 100 SVH section. Again, this could be pixels or whatever. All we're demonstrating is that we've set a value on the height. To see the problem, let's look at this on mobile. Notice how the content is overflowing. Why? Because we set the section to an explicit height, we set a CSS value for height, it doesn't care what's inside. So the section is going to be that height no matter what. So let's try something else. What happens if instead of setting, let's just clear the height, what happens if we set a minimum height? A minimum height means the section will never get shorter than whatever minimum height you set, but it will always respect the content inside. Meaning your section, it'll expand when the content takes up more space. You can set the minimum height to SVH or pixels, or you don't even have to set a minimum height. But put simply, if you're looking to make sure a section never gets shorter than the full viewport height, but still respects the content inside, a best practice is this. Set your section's minimum height to 100 SVH. So, VH, deceptively uncaring when it comes to the browser UI. DVH, pretty great, except when it's not. And SVH, usually the best of both worlds. And of course, minimum heights mean your content will never get smaller than the minimum height, but it'll expand as needed. Unfortunately, we didn't use SVH on this video, so the content will get clipped